Please welcome the New England New Music Ensemble. It's a chamber music group that performs unique and daring original compositions, along with arrangements of songs one doesn't normally think of as chamber music. From the Beatles to Electric Light Orchestra, from Eric Satie to Bartok, from Duke Ellington to Sun Ra to Miles Davis, from Yes to Genesis to Star Wars to Looney Tunes and Merry Melodies. Please welcome the New England Music Ensemble.
Thank you. produce the pieces, or at least that's what we say. That was a piece called After the Ordeal, which, after being out in this weather, is probably an appropriate title. It's a song by Genesis off the album The Land Lies Down on Broadway. Not something you would normally hear with a group like this, though then again, you might not normally hear a group like this either. So that was the last album Peter Gabriel is on for any of you Genesis fans out there. Oh, the next piece is one I wrote. It's called The Provenance of Certain Items. The title doesn't have awful lot of meaning other than I kind of like the way it sounded. This is probably more tonal than most pieces I write. It's one of those things that just came to me one day, and those are the best pieces, the ones that just come out.
Back there on the piano. And yourself?
Oh, and my name is Greg Baymetal, and I play clarinet and there's a tenor saxophone back here for later. We're going to ask for a little bit of participation very briefly on a song that you all probably know because tomorrow is Kristen's birthday. So we're going to mortify her and sing to her right now.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Now we'll actually play something. This next song is called Caravan. It was made popular by the Duke Ellington Orchestra. It was actually written by his trombone player and was one of the songs that really started the Latin big band movement. You may recognize it in that it was featured a few years ago in the movie Whiplash. It was the song they worked on for the first three quarters of the movie before they actually started playing Whiplash. So the difference here is that we didn't bother with the drummer. We felt that was kind of superfluous to the whole song. Hope you enjoy.
And also dangerous to any drummer.
There is that as well, yes. So Caravan does have lyrics that you almost never hear. And they go, night and stars above that shine so bright, the mystery of their fading light that shines upon our caravan. So we hope you enjoy our rendition.
Thank you.
Room is a piece that I wrote for this group. It's entitled Basement Music. I got the name for two reasons. First of all, we rehearse in Robert's basement. So it felt appropriate to write music in celebration of the rehearsal space that we play in. But also, after we finally agreed on what our final instrumentation was, you'll notice that we are primarily a group of low instruments in general. So I sought to write a piece of music that celebrated that low aspect, low range of our group. Hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
Thank you. Welcome to part of the program where we stand and stretch.
The next piece that we're going to play for you is called Clapping Music. It's exactly what it sounds like. It's a piece that's for clapping. So we're going to set our instruments down. And the composer of this piece is Steve Reich. Steve Reich is still living, and he's a composer that was part of a minimalist group of composers. So many kind of pare music down to sort of most basic elements. Hence his attraction to the idea of clapping, that you don't even need instruments, you don't need anything special. It could be done by anyone. And I want to leave you with this image before we play this piece. This is a piece part of phase music. So if you've ever really carefully watched windshield wipers, I did this when I was a kid on the bus. There's like the two windshield wipers, and they're just like you're waiting for that moment when they actually sync up, and otherwise you're like just a little bit off and more off and less. This piece is just like that. So we will start together and we will end together, but in the middle we kind of phase. So it's a pretty interesting idea.
I don't know if I can do this. My hands are sticking together.
Well, it'll be a different timbre today.
A different timbre.
Tuning.
So it's a modern interpretation of his 1911 classic. It's also only a minute long, so.
Last time we played it, there.
What?
They do have to dance.
Yeah, well, in your minds, maybe. That's
thank you.
has a tendency to write shorter pieces than me. This next piece of mine is maybe the longest on the program, but don't let that worry you. None of them are all that long. This one is called The Forgotten Hand of Metal. This came about because I was reading an article in a guitar magazine about exercises for heavy metal guitarists. I'm back on the whole heavy metal thing again, you might gather. I liked the concept, and I wondered what it would sound like with different instruments. And also, I threw in some blues lines and some other things into it, so that there's kind of this driving heavy metal, but you'll hear the saxophone and other instruments pick up these other lines here and there. And we've been working on this one for a while. It's a bit challenging, but I think we've got it down, yeah? We got it.
Thank you. friends and retired actuaries in Omaha, and something of Jack Nicholson. So they said, for today, I can introduce a piece that needs no introduction. I hope you like it.
Thank you. by the Beatles that is indicative of their spiritual development as a group. By 1965, when the song was written, George Harrison was studying sitar with Ravi Shankar, who encouraged him to include sitar in the album recording. Ravi Shankar became a mentor to the Beatles, and his association with the Beatles increased his own popularity. George Harrison would later lead the Beatles to study with another famous Indian influence, Maharishi Mahesh Yogi.
hot day. And thank you for having us.
And excuse me, could you please introduce yourselves to our audience?
Sure.
Oh, we did that.
We did, but we can do it again.
What's more?
So I'm Robert Rabinowitz. I'm a fluted soprano saxophone. Some people have asked me, that's a soprano sax, in case you were wondering.
I'm Greg. Greg Vamel, clarinet and tenor saxophone.
I'm Emily Boyer. I play horn. You can call it French horn.
Scott Provost Switzer, I play bassoon and contrabassoon.
Kristen Provost Switzer, and I play the cello.
Phil Crevier, keyboard.
Okay.
I hear there are refreshments in the other room for anyone who's interested, and we'll stick around if you have any questions or